The scripture reading from this morning comes from the book of Genesis, chapter 17, verses 15 through 17. God said to Abraham, "As for Sarai, your wife, you shall not call her Sarai, but Sarah shall be her name. I will bless her, and moreover, I will give you a son by her. I will bless her, and she shall give rise to nations. Kings of people shall come from her." Then Abraham fell on his face and laughed and said to himself, "Can a child be born to a man who is 100 years old? Can Sarah, who is 90 years old, bear a child?"
Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable to you, O God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. So when was the last time you had a good laugh? I hear a few giggles. I mean a good-natured, really deep belly laugh. The kind of laugh that brings you to your knees, maybe even tears. If you've had too many children, maybe running to the restroom. A really, really good laugh. Can you think of something? Now, try and remember what it was that was so fun. Can you remember? Maybe something someone did or said. Maybe a good joke, maybe a funny movie or an innocent prank. You know, you've seen that show, America's Funniest Home Videos, sometimes at the expense of other people. So I'm not talking about that kind of laugh, but good, clean stuff that makes you just crack up. A good laugh. I have two children, as I mentioned, and in the fall, my daughter will be a freshman in college, and my son will be a freshman in high school. Now that's enough to make me laugh. I don't know how we got there, but it's a good laugh. And I recall when they were younger, much younger, that we would be out in the world, and I'd find myself in unique situations, like many of us do. And I tend to be one of those people who wear my heart on my sleeve, with no apologies. If I see something that moves me, it moves me, and I'm not going to hide it. Well, I would often find myself, and still do, in tears. And oftentimes, my children would say to me, "So, are you happy crying or sad crying, Mom? Because that's just the way it is with me. And that's okay." But they didn't know the difference, and there was a fine line, and still is. My daughter graduated a few weeks ago, and I teared up again. And my son said, "Mom, is this a happy cry or a sad cry?" And I said, "Yes." And there's a fine line. And it's hard to always tell whether you're crying from sadness or from happiness. It's hard to tell. This morning, I'm thinking about that kind of laugh that could push you to tears. I think you might know the type, and maybe even have experienced it yourself. Now, when you're reading the Bible, I was looking for one down here, but I don't want to knock everything over, so I'll just leave it alone. But when you're reading the Bible, and I ask you, "So what kind of themes do you have?" And often when I talk to the confirmands that I have been teaching over the years, they'll say, "Oh, love," and you know, other things. Not once did they come back with laughing. It's not a theme that we hear a lot about in the Bible. It does show up about 6 or 7 times, depending upon how you think about laughter. Obviously, it was not a high priority for the writers of the Bible. But today's text, we are talking about laughter. God speaks to Abraham and says, "Abraham and Sarah, right? I don't know about you, but if somebody gave me that news today, laughter might not be my first response. Good news, right? It was good news for Abraham and Sarah because they had wanted a child for many, many, many years. But as the writer tells us, that the time when God spoke to Abraham and told him to expect a child, Abraham was 100. And Sarah was about 90. So think about that. None of you are, like, by looking at you, I can tell, none of you are nowhere near 90 to 100. But imagine another 30, 40, 50, 60 years. If someone were to come to you and God was to reveal to you that you were to have a child, would you laugh or cry? Maybe your answer would be yes. Abraham laughed, all right. Having a baby at any age is quite a shock, but especially at the advanced age of 100, this life-changing event could really turn things upside down. But Abraham knew that God would provide everything that they needed, and Abraham did not question it a bit. In fact, Abraham was pretty sure that because God told them that they were going to have a child, that they would indeed have a child. And I've been thinking this week about what his response might have been. And I imagine it probably went something like this, given our modern day words. Are you kidding me? Can you hear Abraham just go, are you kidding me? I'm 100 years old. Seriously? 100, seriously? And my favorite one from my son is, dude! When he can't believe something, that's usually the response I get. Dude, really? Well, I sure hope Abraham was sitting down for that news. Because the text tells us that he fell on his face. Now, falling down is no easy matter to begin with, but when you get to be 90 or 100, it's downright dangerous, right? I imagine we all have friends and family and neighbors and things that we know who have fallen at older ages. And it's not fun and it's not easy. So when the text tells us that Abraham fell on his face with laughter, there could have been tears there too. He fell on his face. And I imagine it probably sent him into some tears as well. Then there's the idea of how Sarah responded to all this. She was in disbelief, absolutely shocked. Her response of laughter, though, was more subdued and on the inside, the text tells us. Not outright like Abraham, showing his feelings to everyone, but more subdued on the inside. And Sarah has often been thought of as keeping her laughter inside as a way of being distrustful or doubtful. She couldn't get over the idea that at her age of 90, that she was told she was going to have a child. She had longed for a child, and it had never happened until now. And she even called herself waxed old. She was not ready for this. And waxed old, she said, was like, means to be worn out like an old garment. She was certainly mixed with feelings of doubt as well as delight. Can you blame her? The thought of becoming parents that late in life must have caused both of them to laugh and cry. These mixed feelings. There is a fine line, that's for sure. This reminds us that anything is possible with God. God is there. No matter how impossible or difficult things may seem, God is with us and loves us unconditionally. Through the joys and the sorrows, with us laughing and with us crying. Several years ago, I came across a UCC pastor here in Wisconsin whose ministry is through song. And you may recognize his name because he travels all over Wisconsin. His name is Brian Sergio. And he has some good music that he shares, especially with the younger ones. And many years ago, I happened to meet him and hear a lot of his songs, and many have stuck. And as I was finishing up my message for today, I happened to remember that he has a song about Abraham and Sarah. Now, I'm no singer. I'm the first to tell you. So I will read you the words, because I think they sum it up rather poetically. He says, Abraham and Sarah were very old and gray. The angel of the Lord showed up and said to them one day, we know you're very old and that you've never had a kid, but God said, you better find a baby crib. And they said, you can't have a baby when you get this old. Abraham and Sarah had to laugh. Oh boy, that's a knee slapper. Ha ha ha, ho ho ho. But now Abraham and Sarah know that nothing is too hard for God. Nothing is too hard for God. Say that with me if you will. Nothing is too hard for God. One more time. Nothing is too hard for God. Nothing. Through laughter and tears, God is with us. Through the joys of life, the celebrations of healthy relationships and babies being born and weddings and anniversaries, birthdays, through all of those good things, the God of love is with us and rejoices. But through the times of life when we are in trial, through death and destruction, through fear and emptiness, God remains with us as well, never leaving us and loving us still. No matter what we face, we are not alone. Thanks be to God. Amen.